Today. This is for those of you who have been practicing, and this will give you something to practice again with this one. Don't forget to go back to the others and memorize and learn on these because they're very important. But today's tutorial, I want to go very simple, and I want to go visual, and I hope that this will be a good beginning for those of you who are following this who do not know how to read music and would like to learn. Now, I believe in the very good basics, so I'm going to start off very simple. I began last tutorial with the notes on the staff line in the spaces, which was F, A, C, E, and spelt case. I hope you've memorized those and put them down, or made some staff lines and wrote them down and found them on your mandolin piece. Also on your mandolin fretboard and string. Now the next one I would like to show here is each note has count. Now here, the whole note gets four counts. If you were playing a music, for example, in 4/4 count, then and you found just only one note looking like this in a measure, then you would play it 1, 2, 3, 4. That would be complete. This is a half note, and it has a stem. It looks almost like this, but a little different. And it, of course, being a half note, tells you that it's half the value of this note, so that would be 2 counts. Now, then you would come along perhaps to something like this. The staff, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 lines. If you can get a book with staff lines in it only for your writing notes, then that's all the better. If you can't, make some. I did. I had to make all my own stuff. I remember learning from small little pieces in a weekly newspaper they used to put out when I was a young person. And I wanted to learn how to read music. That's how it started. I started to find out what this meant and what this meant and what this meant, and that's the way it went. This is the staff, 5 lines, 4 spaces. And here it gives you the notes on the lines, and it gives you the notes in the spaces. So memorize those, please, and find them on your guitar strings, or I don't know why I got the guitar on the mind today, but on your mandolin strings, on your fretboard, and there you will hear the sound and memorize the sound. Now, here again we have the notes now on the staff line, and they are E, G, B, D, and F. And study those and play them on your mandolin and write them out and recognize them and try to connect them with the sound of the key of C that you have learned, because those notes are in the key of C also, those notes. Now here we have quarter notes, and quarter notes means it gets only one beat. in the 4/4 time or whatever timing the music is in. Only one beat. So if you have, and they can have these staffs on them here, up or down, doesn't matter, it's the same thing. They're either on the line or off between the lines of the staff. Now, if you had a piece that had, you want, that you had a whole note, you would hold it down for four counts. So, four counts. And you would associate it with the look of the note. And the half note would be two counts. And you would associate it with the look of it also. Notice? So, and then the quarter note get one count. So if you were playing the music, you would say 1, 2, 3, 4, you would let it count. If you had four quarter notes, then you would beat it four times. But when you play a half note, you count four times and you let it sound. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. If you have a half note, you count it twice, you say 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. If you have a quarter note, there'll be four of them in the measure, maybe, or whatever the measure calls for, the music calls for, you will count it as 1, 2, 3, 4, because there will be four of them in there. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then, so, that's your whole note, 1, 2, 3, 4, or 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Your half note, 1, 2, 1, 2. If there's more than one half note, there's two half notes, then you will get 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So, the next one would be the quarter note, and if there's only one note in the measure, it gets one. If there's four notes, you play all four. 1, 2, 3, 4. You see what I mean? So if it's 4/4 time or 3/4 time, it depends. If you got a 3/4 time piece, and you find yourself with, for example, a half note, you say, 1, 2. And then if you got a quarter note in there, you play it again. So it's 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. You see what I mean? Those are the visual sounds of music that you're looking at. And actually, it's very pleasant once you learn them all and you get them all in there. Now, don't forget the staff lines, and don't forget where the notes go on the staff lines. And also, there's the frets there. You got to know on your frets, like where. And see? Right up, it just goes A B C D E F G, and the notes are the same. That on the staff, they're just simply A B C D E F G. So if you're playing, for example, if you're playing the note C. The high note C, you would play it there. A, B, C. And that note would be on the space, the one from the bottom up, 1, 2, and the third space of the staff. That note here, C, would be on the third space of the staff, okay? From the bottom up. The space, not on the staff line, but the space. Remember that. And A would be open A, and that would be on the second space of the staff line. And then open E would be on the 1, 2, 3, 4th space of the staff line. And the F would be on the first space of the staff line. They're all quarter notes, so you play F, A, C, E, F, E, E, A, B, C, D, E, F, F, A, G, C, E. E is open. Close. I'm sorry. A is open. And F, F is closed. A is open. C is closed. And E is open. I'm looking at the floor here because that's where my papers are. I should have a stand here, shouldn't I? But if I have a stand, I will next time. Anyway, now, not to make it too much longer, I want you to look at these colors. Those of you who are more advanced, and I want you to think how you feel when you look at these colors in this painting. I hope you can see it all nicely there. It's kind of difficult to get close up. That's a painting I did myself, and an abstract, of course. I hope you will forgive me for showing a painting, but I had no other color to show. I want you to think about what these colors make you feel, and I want you to write, compose a piece of music in response. No matter how long it is or how short, you can end up with a very nice piece. I have mine already written, on the guitar, that is, not the mandolin yet, and I will be working at it some more. Now, I will say thank you for watching, and for learning, and for sharing with me these things. It gives me great pleasure, and I hope that you can still see me here, and not just part of me. I also got myself a new camera with high definition, and I'm busy trying to learn it, and it's a bit puzzling, difficult really, because there's a lot to it. I hope to go and get some good microphones and recording equipment in the near future. So stay with me and be happy and learn to see music and hear music and play music, and bye-bye for now.